Hi, I am Julian Bro. I am an economist and policy specialist. Today, I will be teaching you about how to measure a nation's income, and more specifically, about the economy's income and expenditure. We will first see what a national economy is. Second, we will analyze how to measure a nation's income. Third, we will see what a nation's expenditure is. Finally, we will talk about the difference between nominal and real GDP. First, the national economy. Here is a simplified representation of a national economy. There are two main types of agents, firms and households. There are two main types of markets, markets for goods and services, and markets for factors of production. Households buy goods and services. Those goods and services are produced by firms. Selling those goods and services provides firm with income. In turn, firms buy factors of production in order to produce those goods and services. Mainly, they buy labor and capital, which come from households. By providing their labor and capital, households gain an income with which they buy goods and services, etc. A main way to measure a national economy is GDP, gross domestic product. A basic accounting principle is that the income of an agent must be equal to its expenditure plus its savings. Now, let's talk about a nation's income. First, from the perspective of income, GDP is the total market value of all final goods and services produced within a country in a given amount of time, for instance, yearly, or per semester, or per quarter. This means that intermediary goods, that is to say, goods which will in turn be transformed into other goods, are not included in GDP. In order to measure a production, one must have access to data. This is not possible if the production happens outside of a regulated market. For instance, household production generally does not give way to regulated transactions. This is because, in general, the member of the household who, for instance, cleans the flat or washes the dishes is not paid in money by the other member of the household. There is no contract between the two members of the household. As a consequence, this transaction is not subject to contract law or any classic labor regulation. Hence, household production is not a regulated transaction. Then, there is illegal production on a black market, which is outright fraud. GDP is built by statistical offices, which draw on available financial accounts of official companies. Illegal businesses are not official and do not send their accounts to statistical offices. As a consequence, these two sectors of the economy's production will not be taken into account by GDP or will have to be estimated. So, how can we measure GDP? A first way is to add up all the income of all the producers in the country. This is the nation's income. How is this income calculated? Companies produce value added. Value added is the difference between the inputs of productions and the prices of sold goods. The inputs of production are typically capital and labor. The added value of companies is then, in this sense, the increase in value of the nation's economy. GDP is then equivalent to the sum of all the value added of all the companies based in the country. A second way is to add up all the ways in which GDP is spent. This is a nation's expenditure. This gives this equation, where GDP is equal to C plus I plus G plus E. C is consumption, that is, the consumption of households. I is investment. That is, investment in capital, in production structures, and in inventories. G is government expenditure. In this case, this is what the government purchases. It excludes pure redistributive transfers like Social Security. And E is the net exports of this country. That is, exports minus imports. Finally, one also needs to correct for the evolution of prices in an economy. Prices can increase. This is inflation. Prices can decrease. This is deflation. In order to do this, one must use a GDP deflator, which is a measure of the inflation in the prices of goods produced within a country. For instance, let's say that the GDP growth of a country is equal to 2%, and let's say that all the prices in this economy increased by 2%. Nominally, the GDP grew, but did the real GDP grow? No. As a consequence, the GDP deflator will be minus 2%. There was no real GDP growth. The increase in nominal GDP only corresponded to the general increase in prices of all the goods and services in the economy. Before adjusting for inflation, we talk about nominal GDP. After adjusting for inflation, we talk about real GDP. With real GDP, you can compare this year's GDP to the one of the past year. The process of adjusting for inflation is sometimes referred to as deflation. For instance, this is the quarterly US GDP from 2012 to 2022 in trillion dollars. For instance, this is the quarterly US GDP from 2012 to 2022 in billion dollars. You can see the drop in GDP induced by the COVID-19 crisis. Time for a quick exercise. Calculate the GDP. Here is the economy. Consumption is equal to $2,000, investment to $4,000, government spending to $1,000, savings to $3,000, imports to $1,000, and exports to $2,000. What is the GDP? $8,000? $5,000? Or $11,000. Remember the formula for GDP. Savings are not taken into account, or rather, they are considered inside the investments. In this case, this gives this answer. Answer 1, $8,000. A quick recap. We have seen in this class that a nation's income must be equal to its expenditures. The GDP is the sum of all goods and services produced in an economy. GDP is spent on consumption, investment, government expenditures, and net exports. In order to compare GDP across time, one must adjust for inflation. Nominal GDP becomes real GDP. The GDP is a very important indicator in order to assess the health and growth of a nation's economy. However, it is not a perfect indicator. Thanks for watching. Check out Chegg for more resources on macroeconomics.